your feet. I take another writing from you, I'm gonna take. Get up and shoot it out.
Young Wild West. Maybe you better tell him that shooting me before you get your hands on the Falcon is gonna be bad for business.
No, no, Wilmer. We can't have any of that. You shouldn't let yourself attach so much importance to these things.
Think I'll have to lay off me then.
No, Wilmer. Your plan is not at all satisfactory, sir. Let's not say anything more about it.
All right. I've got another suggestion. It may not be as good as the first one, but it's better than nothing. You want to hear it?
Most assuredly.
Give them Cairo.
Well, by God, sir.
And suppose we give them you and Mr. Shaughnessy. How about that, huh?
You want the Falcon, I've got it. The Fall Guy's part of the price, I'm asking. As for Mrs. Shaughnessy, if you think she can be rigged for the part, I'm perfectly willing to discuss it with you.
You seem to forget that you are not in a position at all to insist upon anything.
Now, come, gentlemen. Let's keep our discussion on a friendly basis. There certainly is something in what Mr. Cairo said.
If you kill me, how are you going to get the bird? And if I know you can't afford to kill me, how are you going to scare me into giving it to you?
Well, sir, there are other means of persuasion besides killing and threatening to kill.
Yes, that's true. But they're none of them any good unless the threat of death is behind them. You see what I mean? If you start something, I'll make it a matter of your having to kill me or call it off.
That's an attitude, sir, that calls for the most delicate judgment on both sides. Because as you know, sir, in the heat of action, men are likely to forget where their best interests lie and let their emotions carry them away.
And the trick from my angle is to make my play strong enough to tie you up, but not make you mad enough to bump me off against your better judgment.
By God, sir.